And we're gonna start off with the Steelers logo. And you can see here how there's like a little gap in between some of the letterings. My goal for this logo is to do it all in one shot, so only one cut at the very end. So I'll have some jump stitches in between. And right now I'm just trying to get a good trace. And at the very end, I'll go back and kind of tweak everything and make sure everything looks nice and pretty. But for right now, get a good trace, make sure my stitch angles are good to go. And one of the big things that I'm doing here, just to kind of keep everything flowing smooth, is I am branching each letter. So branching just keeps everything nice and tight, especially letters that are, they are separate objects, but they're within the same design. And once I finish tracing, it's just a matter of making sure all of my sequence is all in order, making sure my stitch angles are good. And I'm also checking to make sure my underlays are all good to go. But you could see on the right-hand corner, it tells me how many trims I have. At the very end, I only want to have one trim at the very end. And then here, this letter T, I'm just redoing it because the first round, I didn't like how the stitch angles looked. So it's just quick, especially with text. Anytime we're dealing with text, it's really straightforward. We're only making some very basic shapes, especially with this font here. All right, so this is my stitch sample here. Overall, some of the changes I wanna make here. So if we're looking at the letter T, okay, you can see how I have some of that gapping between the bar, the vertical and the horizontal bar. I have a couple gapping. I'm gonna insert a quick bridge, like right between there. So that's one change. And here, when I'm doing my sample stitch out, I just want to make sure that all the letters are at the same height. So if I have any letter that's too short or too small, this is where I kind of can see it. And also, this is zoomed in. Okay, we're probably like at a couple inches away from the actual stitch out here. So in normal everyday life, you know, this would look perfectly fine, but of course, we have the ability to make any changes if we have to make any changes. All right, so go back to the software, and what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna add this underlay. It's like a bridge underlay just to keep that area nice and tight. So, did the final stitch out, and that T looks a whole lot better. All right, so everything looks nice and clean. Height-wise, everything looks sharp. So I would say this logo is ready to go. Okay, even though we have some jumps in between, you can't really tell. You would have to really, really zoom in to tell. I do have good spacing, so you can see between the E's, I have good spacing. And overall, this logo is good to go. All right, now I'm gonna digitize the Arizona Cardinals logo. The text, very straightforward. It does have some sharp ends, like it has like a little tail on some of the letters. So we just gotta kind of extend that area of the corners. This letter Z, I'm breaking it up into three pieces. I just want to make sure my stitch angles are looking as straight as possible. So that's why I broke that one up into three pieces. Letter O, all in one shot. So I'm just doing the inside first, then the outside. And then I set up the stitch angles. the letter N, breaking it up into three pieces. Sometimes I like to digitize, like if we have three pieces to a letter, I like to do them in opposite order just to kind of see which is the overlap here. Then we got the letter C, okay, which is super basic. And then the letter A, I'm just going to kind of copy and paste and resize. Same thing with the letter R. They're at the same ratio, so it allows me to copy and paste and just switch up the size. All right, letter D, very similar to the letter O. And letter I is probably the easiest letter you can do. I already have an N, so just copy and paste that one. Copy and paste this letter A, resize it. Yeah, I got the S, just trying to get good curves here. Set my stitch angles. All right. Looks good. Now it's just a matter of putting everything in order. Okay, so I'm looking at my trims. I want to have two trims at the very end right now. You can see how it's going down as I'm lining up my start stops. And here I'm gonna butt up my text as close as possible. That just eliminates me having to put any trims and for the jump stitches to be so visible. Okay, so in embroidery, a lot of times we just have to kind of move letters around just to avoid the trims. And then here I'm doing the stitch out, kind of seeing, making sure everything is as planned and I don't have any unnecessary trims or anything crazy happening. And this is the sample stitch out. And once again, we are super zoomed in. So any imperfection or anything that is off, when you zoom in this close, everything is highlighted, like everything is times 10. Okay, so we can find some errors. If you were to take a step back or just look at the actual stitch out, it looks perfectly fine, but as we zoom in, okay, I like to zoom in, make sure we get a good view here. And you can see here, like the letter A, like the bar in the middle, it's kind of drooping down. So I'm gonna have to adjust that. My letter R, it looks like right there where it connects, where the three areas connect right in the center. I'm just gonna fix that up a bit. My letter O in Arizona looks a little short, so I'm gonna make sure I pull that up. Let me see what else. So I'm just looking for little small minor details that we can fix up. Like the letter C on Cardinals. Okay, it looks smaller. It looks pretty small compared to the A right next to it. So that's something I want to stretch out. All right, same thing with the S, Cardinals. All right, my letter R in Cardinals, I'm going to fix that up also. So it was a copy and paste from the top one. So fix that up. So just little minor details that I'm going to change. And the good thing about text, it's low in stitches, so it doesn't hurt you to make a sample. It doesn't hurt to test stuff out, okay, because it's a quick sample. That's why I like text. That's why I like logos a lot, because you can really go and do a couple changes, and it's not going to hurt both time-wise, project-wise. It's not going to set you back. So I'm making minor tweaks here. Then I also noticed that the reason why that middle bar was looping, because it wasn't straight, so I straightened it out here. Same thing with the letter R, okay? Just making little minor tweaks, okay? Any of my push pulls that were coming in a little short, I'm just gonna fix those up a bit, okay? Just clean up these little bars. Anything that was looking a little bunched up, gonna clean it up a bit. And here, what I'm verifying is that I wanna make sure on the Cardinals, since the text is a little bigger, I wanna make sure I have a edge run and a zigzag underlay. All right, so we're looking two trims. We're looking good here, about 2,900 stitches. And this is the final stitch out, super zoomed in. Everything looks clean. And what I'm verifying here is making sure all the letters are at the same height. My jump stitches, all my jump stitches, all right, it kind of blends in. Like, you can see them here this close. You take a step back, everything blends in. Everything looks clean. I like the way the R's look. The R's look real clean. This one here is ready to go. All right, my next one, the Atlanta Falcons. Very similar to the Cardinals. Okay, this letter O has a sharp corner here on the top left-hand corner. So just want to make sure I emphasize these little bars and these stitch angles correctly. Letter N, cut it up into three pieces. And then rebranch it out, make sure everything runs smooth. And then this letter S, I'm going to break it up into 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 pieces, all right? I just want to keep, see how it's blocked, like it's blockish, like it has this block look. I want to make sure I keep that block look, making sure my stitch angles are at either 0 or 90 degrees as much as possible. Okay, once we got that, it's just putting everything in order, making sure everything is in order. My jump stitches make sense. Put the correct underlay also. And then I'm gonna butt them up again, because when I'm working with text, I like my text to be close together, just so my jump stitches aren't visible as much. Now we're doing the Atlantic. So just one thing to keep in mind is now we're working with smaller text. This was about 6 millimeters. So, you know, anytime we change height wise and certain sizes, certain rules start coming into play. Do a quick replay, just make sure everything looks good to go. Then this is our stitch out. So a couple things to see here, okay? Couple items to see. My letter A, it's too much going on the top. The top of the letter T, gotta make that a little bigger, all right? Because sometimes when we digitize according to the actual design, sometimes it doesn't come out right. So we gotta actually make it a little bit bigger. The top bar of the T. Falcons, the letter C in Falcons, actually C, O, and maybe the S. Okay, we're gonna bump it up a bit more. And the A on Falcons, just kind of slightly bring that little bar a little bit down a bit. All right, but overall, looks good. All right, so let's go ahead, let's make those changes. All right, so I'm just gonna redo this A here. Just wanna have a good overlap here. So as long as I have that overlap, it should kind of just blend in nice and clean. And then once I got this A, I'm just gonna copy and paste, send it over to the other side. Right, and here I'm just kind of making little small tweaks, adjusting the push pull here on the letter C's. Any letter where there's pulling on top and bottom. All right, and this is the final stitch out here. All right, let me see. Bam, everything looks clean. So you can see how the word Falcons, everything is perfectly lined up. Okay, you can even pull out a ruler. We can see that everything is perfectly lined up. Atlanta, looking real clean. This one here is good to go. Remember, once you take a step back, everything just falls into place. I like to really zoom in. Here, we got a good view. We can make any adjustments to it, all right? We're so close that I can even see the fabric of the shirt, all right? That's how detailed oriented we are here. All right, let's go to the next one. We have the Miami logo. Okay, we have very thin. Okay, this is very thin. It's very thin font. All right, we have the letter A all in three pieces. All right, put them together, branch them out, put them in order. And then the M and the I, we could just copy and paste. And since it's thin lettering, we just need a center underlay down here. All right, and then everything looks good. Now we could do the Dolphins portion. Here with the letter S, I was gonna do it in one shot, but we could see here where I didn't really like the stitch angles. The stitch angles were too tight, like the way they were moving. So sometimes with the letter S, I'm just gonna break them up into pieces. So here I wanted that middle bar to be as straight as possible. That's why I broke it up into pieces here. Set the stitch angle. All right, so actually I'm doing it in three pieces here. And then once I got everything good to go, I'm just fixing the order, branching them out correctly, setting correct underlay. Now for this bottom part, this is kind of like the orange shadow. When you measure this, it measures out to 0.5 millimeters. So it's too small for a sand stitch. Like if you're trying to get it perfect, it's too small for a sand stitch. So instead of trying to do something super tiny, I'm just gonna run a running stitch down below. And actually not just a running stitch, but a triple running stitch. So I get three pieces of thread Okay, so it goes forward, back, forward. All right, and then we just line it up, make sure everything lines up good. And then, so this shadow part, the orange part, that'll be the first part that'll get stitched out. So then the sand stitches could go right above it. All right, and then I'll put running stitches where possible. Okay, so here, putting the running stitches, and that'll just get covered up by the sand stitch from the dolphin sand stitch. All right, and then when I put these running stitches, just make sure everything runs smooth so I don't have any unnecessary cuts. Of course, at the very end, I'm just making sure all my start stops, my jumps are correct. So this is the stitch out here. And one thing that I'm noticing, it's kind of like you can see some gaps in between the lettering. All right, so what I'm gonna do, just so we don't get these gaps in the word dolphins, I'm gonna add a edge run. Okay, even though we're thin, I'm gonna make an edge run, but I'm gonna keep the edge run close to each other. Another thing that I see on the M in Miami, instead of having them blend together, I'm just gonna fix the overlap on the letter M so it doesn't look bunched up on the corners of the M. On the shadows, so on the dolphins, you see the gold shadow. What I'm gonna do, I think right now it has a triple running stitch of 2.0. I'm gonna change that to a 3.0 millimeters. So those lines, they don't look as small. And that's the good thing about having your files, where you can go back and just make your own little small tweaks. All right, so I'm just gonna fix these overlaps on the M. I'm gonna adjust the underlay. I'm gonna add some, instead of just having a center run with a zigzag, I'm gonna have an edge run with a zigzag. And I'm gonna adjust this gold shadow. I'm gonna adjust it to a 3 millimeter triple run stitch. So here on the final stitch out, all right, looks very clean, very sharp. I like the way the text looks here. Looks very clean. I like the shadows. The shadow looks good with the gold shadow on dolphins. All right, everything is lining up good. My M's, so the corners of the M's. Okay, now we got nice clean blend right there. All right, overall looks very, very clean, especially when we're zoomed in this close. Okay, so you know if we're good this close, we're definitely good if we take two steps back. So overall, these four designs are good to go. If you have any questions or comments, leave it down below, and I'll see you on the next one. Peace out.